land we're meeting on and pay my respects to the elders past and present. As you all know, this land was never ceded. It always has been and always will be Aboriginal land. As Justin said, amongst my many responsibilities, I do have the portfolio of the environment as well, one that I relish and love with a passion. I am an environmental and a civil engineer, so I really love, as I was talking to Anne earlier, I really love the sub-theme of infrastructure going through your work as well. I think it's really, really important that we preserve water infrastructure in public hands and not privatize it. But there are, and most of my 20 years of working about actually has been in water management, looking at the connections between catchments and water and how we actually plan for the future where we don't over-extract water and we don't over-produce water, which is really what has been happening over the last few decades. The facts on water are quite clear. Australia is the driest inhabited country on Earth. We cannot deny that. We also know that water, although a renewable resource, it's a finite resource. So those are really important things to consider when we make decisions. Unfortunately, our governments are willfully ignoring that and also willfully ignoring the fact that climate change, which is taking hold now, is going to have an impact on how we source water. It's going to change rainfall patterns. It's just going to be very unpredictable. So there's more reason to make sure that we preserve, enhance and protect what we have. And as Justin said, the Greens have been standing side by side with you, shoulder to shoulder, hand to hand, over a number of years, against coal seam gas mining. And also, we've just announced a couple of weeks ago, we actually want to wind down coal mining as well. Our future is not fossil fuel based. Our future is 100% renewable energy. And we can do this. We can do this while we create tens of thousands of new sustainable jobs that go way into the future. We do know that the world is weaning off coal. And once that happens and we don't have a plan B, all our workers in that industry will be left jobless unless we start thinking of transitioning people now. So it's for the prosperity of our people of New South Wales and for the planet. As I was thinking about coming today, I remembered something Lord Byron said a very long time ago, which was, "Till taught by pain, men know not water's worth." Unfortunately, that's what is happening at the moment. But I do think, as a society, we are clever enough not to inflict that pain upon us, and to act now and to change things right now. And you have the power. It's always been the people who have created the change. Yes, in parliaments, our politicians of course support you and be your voice, but really all the power is in your hands. So use that power now in grassroots movements, and use that power on 28th of March as well, and make sure that you bring more people in who will actually stop mining, stop coal seam gas exploration, protect our land, our water and our future. Thank you.